people travel for health reasons. One of them is medical tourism. If I'm a patient, I will go to a doctor in another country and do my surgery. This is medical tourism. And by the way, Austria already is attracting medical tourism. 10% of the patients in the private sector in Austria are foreign patients. They are coming for treatment. But not only that, there are Austrian patients are traveling abroad for having treatment. This is one sector, medical tourism. The second is dental tourism. A lot of Austrians are going to Hungary, to Croatia, to have dental treatment or cosmetic procedures. And the third is the spa. Spa tourism is something expanding. Again, Austria, Jordan, Slovakia, Czech, they have destination for spa tourism. And spa tourism is, again, is a huge industry. Wellness tourism. I have studied that Austria is considered the fifth largest wellness market in the world. So this is another industry that people must start thinking about it and promoting it. And I thank Mariana, his study, which he's doing, I think he need all the support that is needed, because this is something huge. It's a big industry. Wellness tourism in the world is about $3 trillion. So it's something huge. It's a big industry. The sport tourism. How many people travel just to do sport? Skiing, hiking, diving, you name it. Billions and billions are spent because people love to do sport. So this is again another issue which is so interconnected between health and the travel. When we talk about the senior citizens, the assisted residential tourism, those who are now 75 or 80 and they are looking for a healthy life and they want to spend a few years abroad, where do they go? Portugal, Jordan, Austria, Spain, Italy, they want a peaceful, nice place with a good weather, and at the same time, they want to be sure that there is a health service that can support them, because at this age, they will have so many illnesses that need to be taken care of. So this is another issue that is, again, linking between health and travel, health and then tourism. He will not go to a country where he doesn't make sure that if he needs his consultation, he needs his medicine, if he has a heart attack, he will not find somebody to take care of him. And the final one is the accessible tourism, which is tourism for all. I think I would like to thank Ingram, because what he's doing is trying to help those people. The WHO, they estimated that 15% of the population, which is about 1 billion people, have special needs. Mm-hmm. Doesn't have to be on a wheelchair. Special needs, he might be a senior, very old age, he might be a child, he might be deaf, he might be blind. These people, they have the right to travel. Are we helping them? Well, the European Network for Assisted Tourism, ENAT, which is a European association, they made a study in Europe, and they discovered that 10% only of tourism services providers, like hotels, for instance, only 10% are accessible. I mean, if I am in a wheelchair, I can get into. If I am blind, I can get into. If I need support, I can. Only 10%. You can imagine that so many millions of hotels and spas and resorts that are not accessible by those people who need assistance. So I think, again, accessible tourism is the right. It is your right if you have a special need that I, as a service provider, as a tourism provider, I must make sure that my facility is suitable for those who has special needs. So if we manage to look at these 8 segments of healthcare travel, I think we will start thinking properly, and I think we can achieve what Marianne is trying to do. Thank you.
Vielen Dank. Das war eine interessante Perspektive, Medizintourismus so weit zu fassen, dass man eben auch Sport beispielsweise mit einbezieht.